Hi, so today I wanted to talk to you more about why food doesn't soothe you and actually makes your emotional eating worse. So welcome. If you're new here, my name is Michelle. I'm a certified holistic nutritionist and emotional eating expert. And I really wanted to talk about this topic of soothing yourself with food because a lot of clients that come into my world, they're at this place where they recognize they use food to soothe themselves, that they're having a lot of anxiety or a lot of heightened emotions, and then they automatically go towards food. So this is a great place of awareness to be at because it means that you're starting to see the pattern. And so, we all know when we're in that place that we're feeling this anxiety and this discomfort, and we have the food and it temporarily calms us down. It temporarily soothes us. And so this is very temporary. So whenever we eat, whenever we feel an uncomfortable emotion, what happens when we eat food in our body? Our body naturally produces feel-good chemicals. So we feel good temporarily. We feel soothed. We feel calm. But this is temporary and it's not getting to the root of what's going on. It's not getting to the root of your emotions. So if you were feeling any anxiety or any discomfort, and you decided in that moment to sit with those emotions and you were very allowing and accepting of them and you really felt through them and allowed yourself to hear whatever messages they had and your nervous system went back to calm and then you decided to eat, it'd be a very different situation. But right now what you're doing is you're using food as a cover up to your emotions to just temporarily take away the pain. It's not actually because of true hunger. It's not actually because you have a physical need for food. It's more of a mental way of calming your body down. And so as we start seeing, there's this deeper pattern. And the deeper pattern is that we somehow decided, either through our parents or society, that it was much better to not feel our emotions and we needed a way to handle them. Or to cope with them. And so for us, we use food to cover it up and just take away the discomfort. And part of the reason we do that is that we weren't, first of all, taught how to be with our emotions, that they were completely okay to have emotions. Maybe we were told that we're weak, we aren't strong enough. We probably absorb that from society. We don't want to show our emotions. We're not allowed to. We're not allowed to be angry. We're not allowed to be sad. We're not allowed to be frustrated. We're embarrassing if we're having big emotions, especially when we're younger. And so we might actually have been given food to calm us down, or we decided, hey, food makes me feel really good. I'm going to use that as the way to handle any discomfort in my life. And we see it everywhere around us, when we say I'm a foodie and all of this, we really take food as enjoyment. And there's nothing wrong with having food as enjoyment, but when we're using it to this level, it becomes sort of an addiction. And so, I want to just help you sort of break this pattern a little bit by sharing with you that emotions are natural. They are physiological. They're in our body. We create emotions in our body. It's like when we talk about serotonin, it's that, happiness, when it's that neurotransmitter that we feel when we're feeling happy, or cortisol is stress. Every emotion, we feel it. We've just decided in society that maybe some emotions or in our family are not meant to be felt. Doesn't mean we're not feeling it in our body. And so what happens is our body creates a chemical response to our whatever we're feeling. It's a message. It's giving us information about our environment or how we're feeling. And it's information. Emotions are internal messengers. They're information. They're data. They're giving us information. And it doesn't mean this information is we're always going to follow what it says. But it's giving us information about what we're doing from a body level, a feeling level. And so if we don't listen to the information and feel it and let it kind of move out of our body, our nervous system doesn't go back to calm. What happens with most of us is that we feel an uncomfortable emotion and we automatically freeze up or sort of contract. And that's because we're telling ourselves we shouldn't be feeling this way, that it's not a great idea to feel this way, And we might not be doing it consciously. We're doing it sort of subconsciously because we were either punished or shamed for feeling the way we were feeling. And so we kind of tighten up, but we're feeling that discomfort in our body. And so whenever we feel that discomfort in our body, you know, we go towards the food to just make us feel a bit better, feel more relaxed. Because that anxiety and whatever emotion we're kind of feeling and it's not going away, it's not coming out of our system, it's because we're tightening up and not letting it, we're not allowing ourselves to fully feel it. Emotions, sometimes it takes 90 seconds to feel it. It could take 10 minutes. They don't last forever. They're just giving us information and we're just meant to feel it. We are feeling beings. We have emotions for a reason, but in our society, we like to think we have to be logical and we don't have any kind of feelings and we're too sensitive or we're too weak or we're not empowered if we don't feel our emotions. We're actually less empowered when we don't feel our emotions. Our emotions are needed to help develop our logical brain, which is our prefrontal cortex. We're developing, it's developing until our early 20s. And the way it matures and develops is by us actually feeling and processing our emotions. So when we hold it in and we are trained to kind of hold it in, we're preventing our development. We're preventing ourselves from having more perspectives and, you know, seeing the world in this more open space. We're actually preventing ourselves from being logical and seeing things more clearly in the world. So that's a little bit about emotions and why it's so important to feel it. But as emotional eaters, we've been shamed. And so we use food to really cope with that. And so this is the pattern. We have to come back to really learning to normalize feeling in our body. So we need to learn how to accept our emotions, how to feel them, that it's totally okay to have them, and that, you know, we need to learn how to process them. So actually sit with the sensations and feelings in our body and let them move through us and allow whatever emotional response we have, whether it's a shaking or crying or feeling that constriction in our body, allowing ourselves to feel it. So this obviously becomes difficult when we have such a rigid mindset around our emotions happening at this deeper level, at the subconscious level, because we might want to consciously feel our emotions, but there's this part of us holding us back. And so this is where the deeper work needs to happen. So I can tell you that, you know, our emotions don't make us weak, that, you know, and some ways to start getting into that subconscious is to start journaling. You know, you can start journaling and really start dismantling your beliefs around feeling your emotions. Another way, and this is the way I work with clients, and these are the meditations I share with them in my program, the Emotional Eating Evolution Program. They are somatic meditations that when they work one-to-one with me, I go deeper into parts work and in our child work, and then they also can do the meditations themselves. And the reason I say that is that the part of you that's holding you back from feeling or saying you can't feel your emotion is a part of you that's trying to protect you. And it might be really, really ingrained, and we need to access it when you are more in a meditative state. It might be hard to access it consciously. And so this is just a way we can work with that part and transform it. We can mature it and give it new information and help it grow out of this pattern. And that can happen, you know, sometimes very quickly, and it might take more work, but it's so possible. And it's what I've done for myself and other clients. And so I just want to say that emotional eating is not something you have to live with forever. If you really recognize what it is, it's a pattern. There are parts of you sort of holding you back from feeling your emotions. You yourself watching this might not even recognize what emotions are. And hopefully through this video, you've come to understand a bit more about emotions and that they're perfectly acceptable and we need to allow them. They're so important for our development. And if we have this pattern, we might not be aware of these deeper parts of us, and we need more support around that. And so this is what I do for clients through the program. They can do it on their own and empower themselves. And there are also one-to-one sessions with me, because when we're starting this journey, it's important to have modeling and someone to hold that container for you to really move through the emotion and to actually see you, hear you, validate what you're experiencing and have that deeper empathy. And that's what I give to clients. And so that is how we move out of this pattern. It's not with another diet or exercise. Of course, nutrition and nourishing your body is super important, and that's part of the program and body acceptance. But this emotional wellness piece is really a big piece in this pattern and really practicing it. So if what I'm saying is resonating with you and you do need more support and you need a step-by-step plan and community, please reach out and book in a complimentary call and assessment for the Emotional Eating Evolution Program. This call is to give you more clarity, and if you're ready to commit to yourself, then this call is definitely for you. So thank you so much for watching. If you have any questions, please leave them below, and please be sure to like and subscribe, and I look forward to sharing more with you, and I hope you have a great day.